The Windows 8 Consumer Preview was released on February 29, 2012. Windows 8 was reinvented from a core of Windows 7 with speed and reliability in mind. It features an all-new touch interface for tablets and touchscreens called Metro. This is for the public to use and review the operating system Microsoft wants to release sometime in the fall of 2012. Now, you probably don't want to upgrade your main computer to this version, as there might be bugs or other issues that won't be resolved in the beta stage. I'd recommend that you install a fresh copy of Windows 8 Consumer Preview on a secondary computer, or that you install it in a virtual machine like VirtualBox or VMware. I will place a link on screen to another tutorial showing you how to download, install, and set up VirtualBox if you want to do that first. For this tutorial, I'll be installing it on VirtualBox. Let's download the Windows 8 Consumer Preview. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. Now, I have Google already set as my homepage. If you don't, go up in the address bar, type in google.com, and hit enter. Now in the search field on Google, you want to type in Windows 8 Consumer Preview. Now the first link you should get here should be Windows 8 Consumer Preview, and it should go to windows.microsoft.com/en-us/windows-8/consumer-preview. Now click on this link. Once the page finishes loading, scroll down a little bit, and then click the Get It Now button. Alright, now scroll down a little bit again. In the middle, you'll see a Download Windows 8 Consumer Preview button. This is if you already have Windows running, like I do in this case, and you want to install Windows 8 on the same computer. Now what we're going to do here is we're going to download the ISO file, which is a single file that contains the format of a CD or DVD. We're then going to burn this ISO image onto a USB drive, and we can use that to install Windows on this computer or any other computer that we want. Alright, so underneath this button, you'll see where it says, you can download Windows 8 Consumer Preview in ISO format instead. Click ISO format. Okay. Now scroll down again, and you'll see the links at the top here are in English. You have download links for both 32 and 64-bit versions of Windows 8. I'll put a link on screen here to another tutorial that shows you how to check your Windows 7 or Windows Vista system to see if it's 64-bit or 32-bit. Most modern systems are 64-bit. However, if you're unsure and you don't want to check, 32-bit will always run on a 64-bit system, but 64-bit won't run on a 32-bit. So you can always download 32-bit and that will run. Especially if you're just testing, it's not going to make that big of a deal. So I have a 64-bit version of Windows 7 here. So I'm going to and the computer I'm going to install in is 64-bit. So I'm going to click the download button for the 64-bit version. On the download information bar, I'm going to click the little down arrow button next to save, and then click save as. I'm going to select the desktop, and we're going to click the save button. Now while this is downloaded, we're going to go download one other piece of software. This is the Windows 7 USB tool. This is used to take an ISO image, like what we're downloading here, and turn it into a bootable USB drive. So, you can open up another web browser if you want. I'm just going to click to open up a new tab. Open up another Google browser. Now, in the search field, I'm going to type in Windows 7 USB tool. Press Enter. Go to the first link here on the Microsoft Store. We'll scroll down a little bit. And under the installation steps, you want to click on the link where it says Windows 7 USB DVD Download Tool Installation File. Alright, again on the download information bar, click the little down arrow, Save As. To the desktop, we'll save. And then click the Save button. Okay, let's click View Downloads to bring out the Download Manager. And then we can just minimize this. I'm going to pause this video until the download finishes, and then we'll pick up from there. Alright, now both the ISO file and the USB tool have both been downloaded. Let's go ahead and open up the USB tool and install that. Double-click on the file. Click the Run button. On the Welcome screen, click the Next button. And then on the Ready to Install screen, just click the Install button. On the Completed screen, click the Finish button. There's now a new icon on the desktop that says Windows 7 USB DVD Download Tool. Let's start the USB tool by double-clicking on it. We need to choose the file. Let's click the Browse button. Go to the desktop or wherever else you saved it. Select the ISO file. Click the Open button. Now click the Next button. Choose the media type. Here we can choose either a USB device or we could burn to a DVD. Let's select USB device. Now we can see that it selected my E drive. It's the only choice, and that is the correct one. Click the Begin Copying button. Now there's files on this disk, it hasn't been formatted. So it's going to pop up with this message saying that there's not enough free space. I'll click the Erase USB device button. It'll warn me that this is permanent, I'll go ahead and click Yes. It'll then go format the drive, and then copy all over the installation files. Once the drive has been completed successfully, just click the X to close out. Now if we click on the Start button and then Computer, we can see the removable disk here. And it has all our Windows installation files on it. Alright, so now we have the USB drive created. We can put it into any computer that we want and install with the Windows 8 Consumer Preview. As I said before, I'm going to install this into VirtualBox as a virtual machine. I'm going to go ahead and create that now. If you're going to install this in a physical box, you can go ahead and skip over this portion of the setup. In the VirtualBox Manager, I'll click the New button. On the Create New Virtual Machine wizard, on the Welcome screen, I'll click Next. I'll select Windows 8 64-bit for the operating system version. We'll call this JAGWin8. Next. Give this 1 gig of RAM. Create a new startup disk. I like to use VMDKs because they're compatible back and forth with VMware a little bit easier. Click the Next button. Do a dynamic allocation. 20 gigs. And I'm going to select a new location. I like to store all of mine on a secondary disk. Gives a little better performance. Create a new folder. Save. Next. And create. Just because it's easier, I'm going to connect this virtual machine to the ISO in which we downloaded, not actually to the USB drive. But the steps will be exactly the same. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and start this. On the Windows Setup screen, we can change the language if we like, as well as the time and currency format, and the keyboard. The defaults are all good. Click Next, and then click the Install Now button. On the Enter the Product Key to Activate Windows screen, we have to enter the product key to be able to continue. Back on the screen where we downloaded it, now without the VMware tools, I can't just copy and paste that over. So I'm going to have to move that down and then copy that by hand over. The key that everybody uses for the English version here is all going to be the same. So it's DNJXJ7XBW8-2378T. X-2-2-T-X, and then finally B-K-G-7-J. Once you enter it correctly, the Next button will become enabled. Go ahead and click that on the License Terms screen. Read the License Agreement. Click the select I accept the license terms, and then click the next button. On the which type of installation do you want screen? You can either do an upgrade or a custom install. We're going to do an installation from scratch here, so we'll select custom install. On the where do you want to install Windows screens, we can see here the 20 GB disk that we allocated when we created this virtual machine. Let's unselect Drive Options Advanced. I'm going to create a new partition here. We'll leave it as the full size, click Apply, click OK. Now we'll format the drive, click OK again. Here we can see we have the main partition, that's most of the drive, and then we have 350 megabytes that's system reserved. We're going to be installing it on disk 0 partition 2. So we'll leave that highlighted, and then click the next button. On the personalized screen, enter a name for the computer. We'll call this Win8 Test. You can change the color if you'd like. I'm just going to keep it as the default. Click the next button. Now you can go through and you can use the express settings here, or you can customize to get more granular and be able to select individual settings. For ease, let's just select Use Express Settings. Now, to sign into your PC screen, Microsoft wants you to sign in with an email address, and they promise that they won't send you any spam. You can do this if you like, and I probably will here in the next couple days, but for this tutorial, I'm not going to do that. To bypass this, we just have to click Don't want to sign in with Microsoft account. Now, again, we're just going to bypass the Microsoft account and create a local account. So to do so, we'll click the local account button. And this is just like it is in the old versions of Windows. You're creating a regular user. I'm just going to call this JAGTutorials. And then I'll click the finish button. It's now going to finalize our settings and bring us into the new desktop. Now here we are loaded to the Windows desktop as our user JAGTutorials. The tiles that we see here are the Metro interface. It was based off what they did with Windows Phone. I'm not going to go into any more detail here on this. I'll save that for a future tutorial while I'll go over some of the new features. This was just to get everybody where they could get it installed and up and running and logged in.